Before watching the video, don't forget to subscribe the channel and enable bell notification to never miss an update from us.
Hello everyone and welcome. This is Ashimal Shukla, your current affairs and banking awareness faculty on Entry Platform. And in this video, we're going to talk about daily news events and current affairs. The discussion is going to involve all the major news events that have happened in the past days. The discussion is going to cover as many news events as possible in as less time as possible. So it's going to be more of a theory session where in a short period of time, you get more and greater amount of updates. And the updates are ones which are very important from your examination point of view, so do take notes. For those who want to practice questions, for them we have Everyday Life Quiz. You can take that quiz free of cost on Entry app, for which the link is provided in the description section and in the pinned comment section below. Let's begin the discussion on news events with the first news event related to Tata. Thales Private Limited, which is a wholly owned subsidiary of Tata Sons, has won the bid to acquire Air India for 18,000 crore rupees. Now, Thales Private Limited is the company of Tata Sons. That is, Tata Sons is the holding company of Tata Groups. 100% stake in Air India is going to be retained by them, a full service airline operating in domestic as well as international market. 100% stake in the subsidiary Air India Express, which is a low-cost carrier airline focusing on short-haul international operations, majorly in the Middle East market. 50% stake in the joint venture Air India SATS, airport services on ground and in cargo handling. Now, Air India was initially formed by JRD Tata in 1932. But when the nationalization had been done by Jawaharlal Nehru government, then 100% stake of Air India was moved from Tata Group towards the government of India via nationalization process in 1953. That was for a worth of 2.8 crore rupees. Rewarding scheme for grant of awards to Good Samaritan. Union Ministry of Road Transport and Highways has recently launched this new scheme for the Good Samaritans, rewarding scheme for grant of Good Samaritans, aiming to motivate the general public to help the victims of road accident in all the emergency situations and inspire and motivate others also to save the innocent lives on road. Under this Good Samaritan scheme, a cash reward of 5,000 rupees per incident is going to be given to those who save the life of a road accident victim by administering immediate assistance or rushing him or her to hospital within the golden hour, that is the most important hour for handling the situation of a mishap within 60 minutes of the incident. The golden hour is a last of only 60 minutes to provide the medical treatment. An individual Good Samaritan can be awarded a maximum of 5 times in a year. It's not like every time you are present and you'll be giving an award. 5 times a year is a maximum award that can be given. And it will be effective from 15th of October 2021. Then we have a few one-liners. Asian Development Bank has announced an increase in climate financing goals 2019 to 2030 for developing member countries by 20 billion. That is, it has increased it to 100 billion US dollars recently. Earlier in 2018, it was announced at 80 billion US dollars for climate financing. Then they have increased it to 20 billion dollars more for climate mitigation efforts, including the low carbon energy sources, climate adaptation projects and private sector projects. India has retained the third position in the 58th Renewable Energy Country Attractiveness Index, which was released by consultancy firm EY Ernst & Young. United States has also retained the top position in Rekai, followed by China at the second position, and Rekai is the one which ranks the world's top 40 global markets on attractiveness of their renewable energy investment and the deployment of the opportunities in these areas or in these countries. So the study also highlights all the renewable energy situations in market and various policy decisions that are taken in the market regarding that. Vice President of India, Shri M. Venkaiah Naiduji, presented the 22nd Lal Bahadur Shastri National Award for Excellence to Dr. Randeep Guleriaji. Dr. Randeep Guleria ji is an eminent pulmonologist and director of All India Institute of Medical Sciences or AIIMS. This Lal Bahadur Shastri National Award is presented since 1999 by Lal Bahadur Shastri Institute of Management, which is based in Delhi. And the award carries a cash prize of 5 lakh rupees, a citation and a plaque, and is given to all the business leaders, management practitioners, public administrators, educators, institution builders for their excellence in the professional order of achievement. Department of Biotechnology and the Ministry of Science and Technology has launched India's first mega consortium on One Health in post-COVID times. The consortium has 27 organizations which will be led by DBT, National Institute of Animal Biotechnology in Hyderabad. Varanasi of Uttar Pradesh is going to become the first city in India to use ropeway services in public transportation. Overall, Varanasi will be the third city in the world after Bolivia and Mexico City to use ropeway in public transportation. It's a 424 crore rupees project with a total distance of 4.2 kilometers, which is going to be covered in a time of about 15 minutes. It's a central and state government project in a ratio of 80% by the center and 20% funding by the state government. App named Fishwale has been launched by Assam and is India's first e-fish market. It was launched by Minister of Fisheries, Environment, Forests and Excise Parimal Sukhlabadia ji. Reserve Bank of India has granted small finance bank license to consortium of Central Financial Services Limited and Resilient Innovations Private Limited, BharatPay, and it has named Unity Small Finance Bank. It's going to take over the assets of the liabilities of Punjab and Maharashtra cooperative banks as well. Bharti Airtel and Ericsson have conducted India's first 5G network trial in the rural locations recently. And this is the first such trial which is being done. It was in a Bhaipur Brahman village in the outskirts of Delhi NCR region using the 5G trial spectrum which was allocated to Airtel. 17th edition of Joint Military Exercise, Exercise Yuddha Abhyas 2021 between Indian Army and United States Army is going to take place at the Joint Base Endorf Richardson, Alaska in USA from 15th to 29th of October. And the previous edition was held in Bikaner in Rajasthan in 2021 in the month of February. Indian-American Microsoft CEO Satya Nadella, Microsoft President and Vice Chair Brad Smith, Chief Financial Officer Amy Hood and Chief Environment Officer Lucas Jopa have shared the award for Global Business Sustainability Leadership, that is CK Prahlad Award for Business Sustainability Leadership 2021. The top four Microsoft leaders have received the award for their collaborative leadership to transform Microsoft into a carbon negative company by 2030 and remove all the historical emissions by 2050. This award is given to Ecolab Chairman and former CEO for leadership in individual executive. It was given to Ecolab Chairman and former CEO Douglas M. Baker Jr. And this award was created in the year 2010 by corporate eco firm in honor of the founding advisory board member C.K. Prahladji, which honors the exemplification of fundamental connection between sustainability, innovation and long-term business success in the globalization. MOU was signed between National Highways Authority of India and Tamil Nadu Industrial Development Corporation to develop multi-modal logistics park in Mappedu village in Thiruvallur district of Chennai. The investment of about 1200 crores is going to be made to develop this, and it's going to develop via public-private partnership. And NHAI and NHIDL is given the task of developing these MMLPs. Software Technology Park of India, AIC's STPI Next Initiative, has signed an MOU with Society for Innovation and Entrepreneurship, IIT Bombay, to develop entrepreneurship and boost the startup ecosystem. STPI is in the Ministry of Electronics and IT, and Sign IIT Bombay is going to provide the expertise. Department of Posts has launched digital version of ePLI Bond. EPLI bond was launched in partnership with DigiLocker and developed by National E-Governance Division, Ministry of Electronics and IT, made available digitally via DigiLocker. One Health Consortium was launched by Department of Biotechnology by Secretary of Department of Biotechnology, Dr. Renu Swaroopji. It is led and managed by DBT, National Institute of Animal Biotechnology, which is based in Hyderabad. Shivalik Small Finance Bank has partnered with Go Digital Insurance to offer insurance products via banking network. Insurance products like health insurance, motor insurance, home and shop insurance are going to be offered via this process. Country's first Atal Community Innovation Center was inaugurated at Vivekananda Global University, Jaipur, and is set up by Government of India Atal Innovation Mission and Niti Aayog. Deepa Malik ji has been appointed as Independent Director for hospitality firm Orwell Stays Limited or OYO. Sajjan Jindal has been appointed as the Chairman of World Steel Association, the CMD of JSWC Limited. Meera Mohanty ji has been appointed as Joint Secretary in PMO recently, and Ritesh Chauhan ji was appointed as CEO of Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana. With this, we'll be winding up the segment of the day, and I hope this session has been helpful. We'll see you in the next video. Have a great day ahead.